We met one summer on Half Moon Island. She was 13, I was 11 at least. I knew there was something different about Georgia Rose. By the way she held her arms out to the dark blue sea. Now on our bikes we'd see the postman, Mr. Murdoch. He'd holler out, "Hey kids, how's the ride?" One day Georgia Rose said she saw a cloud around him. Next morning we heard Mr. Murdoch had a heart attack and died. Georgia Rose came to me and said, "Don't tell. It's been going on so long I can't turn it off. I see things that are going to happen. I hate it, I can't help it. It's not my fault. Go home and cry. We didn't say anything about it the rest of the summer. Vacation ended and we drove home to our different towns. I went to Woolworth's and bought my first stationery. Box of blue with a blue stripe, box of brown with a brown. Georgia Rose sent me these neat chatty letters, until one day in February a scrawled card came. Unlike the rest, it said, "Don't worry about your father. He'll be much happier. Don't fear, no one's to blame." Next morning, Daddy gathered us around him. Said he was in love and he was going away. He hugged us and cried and drove out the drive. We went on to school. It was Valentine's Day. Go home and cry. We didn't write anymore then, and it was a long, long time before I saw her again. August 21st at the corn cake, it was my birthday, friends were with me. Sitting on the screen porch celebrating, off in the dunes I saw a woman stretch her arms out to the sea. I left the party and walked out to her. She said without turning, "What took you so long?" In her eyes I saw a great ruined beauty. In that instant, who knows what it was she saw. Georgia Rose lived with me for a time out of time. We had a passion that was all in all. One day her eyes changed and I knew she was singing. "I hate it, I can't help it, it's not my fault, no. Go home and cry your eyes out. It'll do no good to know. You're gonna lose the future if your love is Georgia Rose." Time passed, and I found me a new woman. Maybe that's what Georgia Rose saw. One day I spied her on the main street of my city. She was trying to pretend I was someone she didn't know. I said, "Georgia Rose," and she turned back to me. With her hair gone stringy and circles underneath her eyes, she said, "I'm on my way to meet my new husband. I don't see that he changes, lies, or dies." She said I'm not in love, but I don't care. Maybe that's the way it has to be. I deserve a life and a future too. I deserve not to see.
Georgia.